Forever could never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day.
Hi everyone, thank you for watching. So today I'm going to be teaching you how I got this beautiful bridal makeup look. It's very natural and I'm using a lot of neutral colors, but I think this would be a perfect look for your big special day. I did use a lot of products that are known to be long wear that don't have SPF, and I also use an amazing makeup setting spray that really holds for special events. So I just wanted to let you guys know that I just got a new Sabo skirt discount. Yay! It's been so long since I've gotten a code from them, but I will be listing it below. This beautiful white lace dress is from them. And it's funny because when I got this in the mail, I was like, you know, one day when I get married, I feel like I'll be wearing this to some sort of event that has to do with my wedding. So if you guys want to check out their website, I will be listing that below. And these beautiful earrings are from Ludora Boutique. If you guys want to learn how to get this look, please keep watching. To prime my face, I'm going to be using by Smashbox the Photo Finish Color Corrector. This one is definitely my favorite primer, and I'm going to be applying that all over my entire face. Before this look, I did wash my face and use my moisturizer as I normally would. For foundation, I'm using the Makeup Forever HD foundation, and you want to make sure you're using a foundation with no SPF in it because that's going to give you that white flashback. And I'm mixing this with the Magic Lumi Illuminator, and what this is going to do is just give your skin a nice glowy look. So I'm mixing the two on my hand, and then I'm going to be picking that up with my foundation brush. Next, I'm going to be filling in my eyebrows with the Brow Bar To Go in this darkest brown color. Also, I quickly contoured my nose, but that part was not on camera. But if you guys want to see how I do it, I will link below my highlight and contour video. And then following that, I'm going to be taking the gel part from the Brow Bar and applying that just so my hair stay up in place. For concealer, I'm using by Laura Mercier. This one is definitely my favorite. It's a Secret Camouflage in SC3. And I'm going to be applying this underneath my eyes and also on the sides of my nose just to brighten up my face. And to blend all that in, I'm using this concealer brush from Sephora. Whatever product is left on the brush, you're gonna then bring down the bridge of your nose, also in between your eyebrows and on your chin, and this is gonna finish off your highlight. To set my concealer and foundation, I'm using the Mineral Finishing Veil from Maybelline. This is just a loose translucent powder, and I'm going to be applying that all over my face. To start off the eyes, I'm using the BH Malibu palette, and I'm picking up this cream color, and I'm going to be applying this all over my entire eyelid, also in my tear duct and underneath my eyebrows. Next, I'm picking up this tan color, and I'm going to be applying that on the outer part of my eyelid over the cream color we had just done. Moving on to my 120 palette, I'm picking up this darker brown color, and I'm going to be applying that right over the outer part that I had just done previously with the tan color. And this is just going to accentuate that tan color, make it stand out a little bit more. Going back to my Brow Bar, I'm picking up this dark brown color again, and I'm going to be applying that right into my crease with my MAC blending brush. Then picking up this dark brown matte color from the Malibu palette, I'm going to be applying this with a smaller blending brush right in the outer V of my eye, and this is just going to accentuate your eyes, making them appear larger. Next, I'm picking up this tan pigment from MAC, and this one was one of my first pigments I ever got, hence why it's almost empty. It is one of my favorites, but I'm going to be applying this right on the crease and blending it down into my eyelid, and this is just going to give you a really nice shimmery look. To line my eyes, I'm going to be using a black gel liner. And for lashes, I'm using By Velour. These ones are definitely my favorite right now. I do have a coupon code, which will be listed below in the description box. And topping that off, I'm going to be using this mascara, which is also by L'Oreal, but this one has a fluffier brush, so it's going to prevent me from getting spider-like lower lashes. Following that, I'm going to be lining my lower lash line with that same tan pigment from MAC. For lips, I'm going with the Jordana 20 because I like a very natural pinkish look for this. And following that, I'm going to be using this MAC lip gloss. It's called Talk Softly to Me. The next step is going to be bronzer. I'm using the one I only use, which is the L'Oreal True Match in Cocoa, and I'm just very, very lightly going to be contouring my cheeks, but this is, again, going to be very, very lightly and a very soft look. When applying your bronzer, it's super important not to forget your neck. For blush, I'm picking up this light pink color and I'm going to be applying that to the apples of my cheek, blending that into the bronzer that I had just done. To give your skin that glowy highlight, I'm using by MAC, it's called Soft and Gentle, and I'm going to be applying that right onto my cheekbones. And as you can see, it's really, really shimmery and pigmented. I'm also going to be picking up a little bit with my finger and applying it right on the Cupid's bow of my lips, and also applying a little bit right in the center. And if you saw my previous video showing how to make your lips appear larger, this is one of my techniques. Final step, and the most important in my opinion, is to apply a makeup setting spray. This one is from Model in a Bottle. I got this right off of Amazon, and it's like hairspray for your face, I always say. I love applying it because it's guaranteed to stay on all night, and it's great for formal events and for times where you need your makeup to stay on all night. So this is the final result. For those of you trying this out for your wedding day, the biggest congratulations from me to you. That's so exciting, and I definitely need to see pictures, so please hashtag me if you decide to use my makeup look. And if you guys want to see any other wedding looks, maybe something more dramatic, definitely comment below in the description box, and I'll see you guys next time. Finally showed her mouth.